the bands that have had an absolute huge impact on me growing up was the band Rush. My brother, who is 10 years older than me, introduced me to Rush at a young age, and their work, lyrically, musically, just really connected with me, resonated with me in a way that I don't think that I had ever really resonated with music before until the band REM and Cademan's Call and Tom Petty and Foo Fighters and the bands that are my biggest influences. Rush was really big when I was a kid, and I remember when I was younger, my brother made me a mixtape of his favorite Rush songs, and I listened to that tape over and over and over again while I was mowing the lawn. And we had about an acre, so I had a riding lawnmower, and I would listen to that tape and all those mixtapes that he made me of classic rock as he tried to influence what I was listening to as a younger child. And exerting that big brotherly influence musically, I really look back on those years with fondness and listening to those tapes. And I feel fortunate enough that I saw Rush 3 times before they stopped touring and before the sad departure of the professor, rest in peace, Neil Peart. And I'm pleased to say that I got to take my son when he was 5 years old to his one and only Rush show. That was in 2012. That was our last tour stop in Indianapolis. And so I'm glad that I can share that experience with him, just as my brother took me to my first Rush concert, which was on the Counterparts tour in 1994. Primus opened. That was an experience in and of itself. My brother had seen them several times in the 1980s, and so there were aspects of those tours that still lingered when he saw them. When I saw that show with him in 1994, I think specifically of they used to have on stage these two rabbits, and it was they had. I think they started this in the late 80s. They had a rabbit on each, an inflatable rabbit on each side of the stage. It was part of the shtick, and one of the inflatable rabbits shot a gun, and then you saw this animated bullet kind of travel through a whole bunch of different things when it finally hit its destination, which was the other rabbit on the other end of the stage. They just both, if I recall correctly, they both just deflated. But it was pretty comical. They didn't do that as much in future tours, at least in the tours that I saw them. I saw them on the Test for Echo tour, and then I saw them again on their Clockwork Angels tour. I missed the R30 and the R40 tours, unfortunately. Those shows were... Wait a minute, did I see the R40? I may have seen them 4 times. I may have... Or not R40, R30. I don't know. I can't remember now. But I know I saw them at least 3 times, maybe 4, which is small in comparison to the number of times that a lot of the huge Rush fans have seen them. I can at least say that I took my son to see them. And I'm pleased to have passed down the tradition of seeing Rush and loving Rush to my kids. And I look forward to their influence in the coming years and seeing how they can continue to influence what I'm doing. Even though they don't make any music anymore, I look forward to just their continued influence because they're a great band. Thanks, Rush.